Hey people, what is up? This is going to be my contest entry video response for John Wayne Colt 45 for his awesome contest he got going on. Hey brother, congratulations. You've got 285 subscribers right now. And man, you deserve them. You've got an awesome channel. Great knives on the channel. You know, just it's awesome. So I got to play along here in this contest. So, let's see, you must be a subscriber prior to this video. You know it. No doubt, brother. Show your six favorite knives and tell why they're your favorites. All right. Well, it's this one. This one. This one. This one. This one. And this one. Those are my six favorites. Well, they are really nice. I love them to death, but I'm just messing around. Let's just take a few of these away. I love my Endurance, y'all. Y'all know that. That's not even all of them. That's just a few. This is one of my favorites. Why? Well, for one, it's one of those ones you just can't buy. You gotta make it. I got the red trainer handle and the wave blade. So I had to, you know, cut up two different Enduras to get this one. Or, you know, swap them out. And I just love that red on that waved blade. I think it looks real good. So this is definitely one of my favorites. And, of course, I polished up that clip right there. It's all fingerprinted up. But I polished up the clip so it, you know, kind of go with the red better, in my opinion. And, you know, it's just a real nice blade right there. Definitely one of my favorites. So there's that one. Another one of my favorites. Very, very close. One of her cousins. The Endura 4 G10. This is definitely one of my favorites. I love carrying this knife around. This knife has a lot of pocket time on it. And, you know, a lot of fingerprints on it too. But, man, this knife just is built. It's just really built. I mean, the regular Enduras, they're built really well too, but this one is just overbuilt in my opinion. It's a solid knife. If you haven't felt, you know, G10, Endura 4, anybody that hasn't got their hands on one, y'all should go get your hands on one. These are really nice. Love that knife, y'all. Another one of my favorites. Just found out about this one. For some reason, it took me a long time to get on the bus. But now I'm in love with this one, y'all. You know, the military. I got a few of them now. And the military is just like, it's one of those knives that, you know, if you like Spyderco, you probably should get one of these. You know, if you got the money for one of these, definitely pick one up. I recommend it highly. I just love the Millie. I mean, she's super quick to deploy. And, of course, I'm not doing it right because I'm on camera. But super quick to deploy. Easy to, you know, close up. Feels good in the pocket. Feels good in the hand. Even better than the Enduras, I think. I don't know. I better not say that in front of them. I love the military, y'all. So that's easily one of my top six there. Let's do it this way. How about that? All right, y'all. Another one of my favorites. The Cold Steel Recon 1. The new version. I got this in clip point and a tanto point. I like the clip point a lot. I like the tanto point a lot. I really couldn't pick. But either way, this thing just fits so good in the hand. Solid slabs of G10. Okay. No liners. It's pretty lightweight for, you know, how big it is. And a little front heavy, but a little blade heavy. But, you know, it's a really good knife. It fits better than the military in your hand. And I got me some grip tape back there. You know, it just locks in good. Got that big old beefy triad lock on it. When you open it, boom. Good to go. And I have no doubt that this knife would serve me well. Got kind of a bullshit black coating on it with the, you know, it's paint. It's really not that durable, but you know what? I don't care. It's a damn nice knife. You know, I think it's a good knife, if you want a beater, you know, you want something to carry around with you and beat up on, I think this one would do it. You know, it's just a real solid knife. I love this knife. So that's easily in my top six. Next, we got one of my favorite knives of my whole collection. Excuse me, y'all. My Benchmade 32 Morpho. I got my 51 Morpho as well, but the 32, I just love the way it feels in the hand. You know, it's a little smaller and it's a little more compact, and you know, I can flip it. Of course, I'm not doing that on camera, but it just feels really good in the hand, you know. And you know, I love it. I love the little 32. There's really not much bad to say about it. I like the D2 steel. I like the G10 on top of the, you know, the anodized jewel titanium liners. You know, it's just, I think Benchmade nailed it on this little guy. Or girl, rather. This is my girl. I don't have no boy knives. But easily top six, top three right there. And last but not least, this is one that, you know, I don't know if anybody would think I would like it or not. You know, maybe they would, maybe they wouldn't. But right here. Yeah, I got some custom work on it. I hooked it up a little bit, but the Rat 1, the Ontario Rat 1 folder. Easily top six. This thing, for the money you pay for, it's got $25, under $30, you know. For $130, this knife right here, man, it is badass. I mean, really, if you like knives and you don't have this knife right here in your collection, you better run out and get you one. Because this right here is well worth the money. I mean, I think even more so than the Tenacious. I got a review on the Tenacious versus the Rat 1 here, and it comes out on top. I love the Tenacious, I do, but that Rat 1, man, that thing is just super badass. Comes out like an automatic knife. You push that thumb stud a little bit that way, and it just comes out without any effort at all. Good lockup on it, nice and solid. You know, it just feels real good. Of course, I modified it a little bit, made it feel better to me. But really, you can't ask for a whole lot for $25 more than you're getting this. This knife feels like it should be about $50, maybe more. You know, it's just a badass knife, y'all. So that right there is my top six. And, you know, it changes every now and then. Maybe I'll find something. You know, like if I didn't have this military here, for instance, because I just found out about the militaries. I mean, I knew about them a long time, and I heard people talking about them, but, you know, if I didn't have this one, say I hadn't bought it because I hadn't jumped on board with it, it'd be something like this, the Spyderco Police, you know. I love that Police, just like the G10, really, but or the G10 Endura, but, you know, just a little bigger, a little bit different ergonomics, a little bit different blade, but, you know, for the most part, the same. That'd be there instead, but since I can only pick six, as per the rules, I'm going to go ahead and go with that Millie. You know, you might be able to replace it with the orange one. I don't know. And I got another one, but I think I'm going to upload this video before I upload that video. And I don't want to give it away, so we'll just do that. Anyway, y'all, there's my six favorites. And what's my favorite lock mechanism and why before I run out of damn time here? John Wayne, I'm sorry, brother. I'm making these long-ass rambling videos. You probably ain't got the time to sit there and watch a long-ass video, but my favorite lock mechanism, hands down, gotta be the Lockback. This is the liner lock. Balisong's awesome. You know, really good lock mechanism on that. You know, this is the Triad lock, which is pretty much a beefed-up Lockback with a stop pin right there. Nice and solid. I love that lock. I mean, really, that's the main reason why I bought these Recon ones, because of that lock. I just know it's going to be tough, you know. But just a good old traditional Lockback for me. I'll take that one right there. You know, I've trusted them. I know how to, you know, use them one-handed. You know, some people might want to do a two-handed affair because, you know, they think it's safer or whatever. You know, with my Enduras anyway, I'll just drop it down like that on my finger like that. And, you know, come down here and close it up. I like a Lockback. Now, I love the military, you know. The liner lock as they do it here, really good. Really good stuff. Can't complain about it. And I have no doubts that's going to be a strong knife for me. But, you know, it is easier. I will admit, the liner lock is a little bit easier, as is the frame locks, you know. You can just get it out, push it, close it up, you know, real easy. But for me, personally, you know, on my Enduras and, you know, several others, you know, you can just drop it down like that. Here's my waved Endura. You know, of course, I can just drop it down, close it like that. On this one, I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't drop that one one-handed because you don't got much to work with. You know, you could probably, like, kind of do like that. But that's a little too close. So this one's more of a two-handed affair with me. I kind of just break it like that and then just come up here like that. Or, you know, hit it on something like this and then come back up here and close it like that. I don't know. But I like me a good old lock bat. So there's my six. There's my lock I like. And, I hope you put me in your contest, brother. It's a real good one. And, you know, I like your channel a lot. I appreciate your channel. Every time I go on your channel, bro, I'm like, damn, I need some money. You know? I got money for certain things, but when you bring out some of them knives you got, I'm like, oh, shit. It's a whole new ball game now, bro. You done stepped up the bar, so, you know. I'm jealous of your collection, bro, to say the least. You got some good knives. You know, I'd like to pick one or two out of them. You know, just let me pick. Let me walk in there like I just won the lottery and, you know, pick one or two out of your collection and I'd be good, you know. So, anyway, bro, thanks again. Keep doing your damn thing. Life's short, y'all. Stay sharp.